Shout out to the supporters of Tupac Was Lyrical. This video is called The Complexity of Tupac. I gotta shout out this hater who claims that he's a Tupac fan, but he calls us Pac stans. Name is Viper Records. Says Tupac ain't complex. It was a few people that came on my channel and said Tupac ain't complex. So what we gonna do is show and prove that Tupac was complex. But first, let me run down a few notes that I got here. Number one, Tupac coming from Marin City. First, let me say, this is something that the haters don't pay attention to. They listen to certain songs. They listen to certain songs, or they listen to gossip, or they listen to somebody else saying like, yo, Tupac wasn't like this rapper, or Tupac wasn't like this rapper. And we're going to get to that real quick in a moment. Marin City, where Tupac resided. He said himself that they didn't want to hear all the metaphors. They didn't want to hear that lyrical miracle. They wanted they rhyme straight up. They just wanted you to hit him. Tupac is all about spreading a message. And he has to deliver a message to get the point across. So at that point in time, there was some songs where Tupac wasn't complex and he was just a little bit blatant, straight to the point with it. Made it easy for you to comprehend. There's times when you listen to Tupac songs, how he goes up and down. He'll go complex and then he'll bring it down a little. He'll like say something complicated and then he'll make it simple for you again. He was good at that. And he did that for a reason. Number two, Tupac never claimed to be the best rapper. He claimed to be the realest rapper. He just felt like he just needed to come across this way. Tupac never ever said that he was the best rapper. So it sucks when people say Tupac is overrated. Tupac never rated himself. You don't make songs like Dear Mama, Keep Your Head Up, Brenda Got a Baby, Trap, Violent. You don't make songs like that and claim to be the best rapper. Those are songs with messages. Those are not braggadocious songs. Also, Tupac lived in the Bay Area, although he's from New York. I can only say if Tupac would have stayed in New York, would he still became the rapper that we known him to be? Would his destiny of becoming a rapper, even though he called himself MC New York, but would Tupac be widely known if he would have stayed in New York? We don't know that. But if he did, let's just say if he did and he was New York raised and New York hip hop culture, no Bay Area influence whatsoever, no West Coast influence whatsoever. Don't you think Tupac would have been rhyming like everybody else was? Because let's keep it real. Nas rhymes very similar to Rakim. And very similar to Coogee Rap, with a taste of Big Daddy Kane. That's a lot of MCs in New York. Why? Because Rakim, Coogee Rap, KRS-One, Big Daddy Kane set the standard. They set the standard. Especially Rakim by changing the game. It was so, you had so many people that was coming out rhyming like Rakim and trying to sound like Rakim. At one point in time, you had nothing but 5% MCs running the hip-hop culture in the late 80s, early 90s. That's facts. And Rakim was like one of the first ones. So when you coming up in that kind of culture, you have to write your rhymes like that because Rakim set a standard. So much so that when Big Daddy Kane came out, yeah, like, oh, I got competition. Hardcore competition. So I don't want to sound like Rakim, but I got to do what I got to do. So Big Daddy Kane did what he had to do. KRS-One too. Coogee Rap as well. Coogee Rap was, he didn't brag too much about being the dope MC. He did it on maybe songs in It's a Demo, Men at Work, songs like that. But Coogee Rap was, nobody can touch Coogee Rap when it comes to spitting that gangster lyricism. Nobody can put it together like Coogee Rap. That's why he's in my top five. Nobody can touch that man when it comes to that. The wordplay is incredible. But at the same token, those who came after him, people like AZ, people like Nas, like even, you know, Cormega, so many, a plethora of MCs from New York or just from the East Coast alone. They knew that people like Rakim and all these dudes was going to be listening. You know what I mean? And you had to impress. You had to impress on the East Coast. You had to impress East Coast hip hop fans. You had to. Now, Tupac being in the Bay Area, he's over there in their culture. Although they know about hip hop and stuff like that, they know about New York. But like I just stated, in Marin City, they ain't want to hear all it like that. They just wanted it straight up. They wanted their style. They wanted to do how they do. However they move, that's how they wanted to move. That's why when you hear people like E-40, Too Short, you know what, Spice One, Rich Nice, you know, these dudes is, or Richie Rich, these dudes is different. These dudes is dope in their way because they come from, they on that side of town or they on that coast and they got their own style. Tupac got a little bit of New York, got a little bit of some South in them, some Midwest in them, and definitely the West Coast all in them. You can hear it in this music. A lot of people hate Tupac and don't even know his whole catalog. A lot of people say that you ain't listen to One Nation. You ain't even listen to the other albums, the albums that came out after Tupac died. You ain't listen to that. You probably ain't even listened to it. These haters probably didn't even listen to the debut album, the second album. You probably ain't really get a full grip of the third album. You probably only know the fourth album, which is All Eyes on Me. And another thing is, my homegirl LaQuasha told me that WAC 100 said Tupac Hit Him Up was whack. Now, let me say this real quick, because I said it on the live the other day. A lot of people saying Tupac went too far. A lot of people saying this, that, and the third. Tupac was angry. Tupac was a troublemaker. This, that, and the third. In the last days of his life, a lot of people have real negative things to say about Tupac to this day. But nobody talks about how Tupac arrived to that point. They totally forget that Tupac was raised to be a Black Panther, to love his people. So when a black woman accuses him of rape, don't you think that hurt that man? When Tupac bust at the two white police officers to save a brother's life, and then a year later, he gets shot up by a brother. When he was raised to love his people, to unite his people, to get his people right. Why you think Tupac came at those, the black disciples or the gangster disciples about Yummy Sandifer? Why you think he came at them? Because his passion and his love for black people to do better. So when you get accused of rape and you get shot up and then you get sentenced to prison by the system that the Panthers was against, by the same type of system that came after Asada Shakur, Matula Shakur, Geronimo Pratt, Huey Newton, Fred Hampton, etc. He's angry about that. And now he's in prison dealing with all this other stuff, having people lift your nuts, open your butt cheeks, all this other stuff, dealing with rumors, dealing with threats, hearing crazy stuff about the outside world, and then boom, Suge comes along and bails him out. Now, when it comes to the All Eyes on Me album, Shock G even said that Tupac wanted Shock G to hear the Machiavelli album. And Shock G was like, what about All Eyes on Me? And Tupac said, man, I did that for Suge. This is what I want you to hear. So Tupac did that because Suge Knight bailed him out. So Tupac went into the studio and was just right banging out hits. Banging what he was going through. You know what I mean? His anger, everything. And he put all that stuff out there and he had major hits. Classic bars, lyricism, flows, cadences, all that other stuff, bro. All that other stuff. And then he had the Machiavelli. This is where the complexity of Tupac came back into the picture again. especially because he already presented the complexity of Tupac on Me Against the World. On the first two albums, Tupaculous Now and Strictly For My Niggas, he was just really trying to put a message out there. He wasn't trying to be the best rapper. He wasn't trying to be complex. He had an agenda. And his agenda got sidetracked when he got accused of rape, when he got shot up, and when he went to prison. So this is why people started, this is why when you hear Ice-T was like, yo, you know, Tupac went too far and hit him up. Or Ice Cube would be like, Tupac went too far and hit him up. Or Ed Lover would be like, Tupac went too far and against all odds, he was kind of snitching. And all these other stuff. He was angry. He was paranoid. Tupac told you, prison didn't change me. It made me worse. Tupac said, I wasn't mad until you trick shot me. You rumbled the mind of a young brother who was raised to love his people. And then at one point in time, it became conflicting because he's dealing with a love-hate situation for his people. That's why he would say songs. That's why he would say rhymes like, and they say it's the white man I should fear, but it's my own kind doing all this killing here. That's why he would say things like that. But anyway, hopefully you stayed and really paid attention to the video, because a lot of people don't even listen to my fucking video. They see the title, they might stay for like 30 seconds or a minute, and that's it, and then form their own freaking opinions. You need to listen to what I'm saying. You need to listen to the content. You need to hear what I'm saying, because I hate when you people just comment, and I'm referring to the haters. I hate when these people just comment and just, it has nothing to do with what I said. Nothing. But anyway, I'm about to show you three verses where Tupac was complex. This video is called The Complexity of Tupac. Now let's get into it.
With all this extra stressing, the question I wonder is after death, after my last breath, when will I finally get to rest through this suppression? They punish the people that's asking questions and those that possess. Still from the ones without possessions, the message I stress. To make it stop, study your lessons, don't settle for less. Even the genius asks questions, be grateful for blessings. Don't ever change, keep your essence. The power is in the people and politics we address. Always do your best, don't let the pressure make you panic. And when you get stranded and things don't go the way you planned it, dreaming of riches, in a position of making a difference. Politicians are hypocrites, they don't wanna listen. If I'm insane, it's the fame made a proper change. It wasn't nothing like the game, it's just me against the world.
Not one curse word. Didn't even say, I don't even think he said nigga in there. Not one curse word. No, wasn't no anger in there. It was Tupac straight spitting. It was Tupac showing you that he can get complex. Now, he may not reach the level of complexity that you people want to compare Tupac to. You want to compare him to a Rakim. You want to compare Tupac to a Nas. You want to compare Tupac to a Jay-Z. You want to compare Tupac to even Biggie. You want to compare Tupac to a Pharrell Munch. You want to compare Tupac to a Mos Def. You want to compare Tupac to a Kendrick. You want to compare Tupac to a Eminem. You want to compare Tupac to a Crooked Eye. You want to compare Tupac to a Royce the 5'9". He was him. Tupac was him. He wasn't trying to be like nobody else. But what he displayed on that song, Me Against the World, he still gave you message. He still put a message in there. He gave you jewels. But at the same token, he also was showing you that I'm nice. I'm lyrically nice. I can get busy. That right there didn't sound like no Bay Area type of rapper. No disrespect. That right there definitely sounded like, all right, let me bring that New York out of me now. Let me show these dudes. Let me show these dudes that I can get busy. And one more thing about that. I guarantee you, if Nas said that same verse, y'all niggas would love that shit. Y'all be like, yo, Nas was spitting. See, Tupac couldn't do that. Tupac couldn't spit like that. The difference with Tupac is animated. Tupac is loud, boisterous. Tupac has a unique voice. Tupac has energy. Nas is a laid-back kind of dude, bro. Nas is a laid-back kind of dude. He's not animated, in my opinion, at all. But can the man spit? The brother can definitely spit. But Tupac has all these other things going along for him. So when he rhymes and all this other stuff, he got different flows and all this other stuff. So y'all take that as that not being complex, because Tupac just be switching flows. But y'all don't be paying attention to that. That hate won't allow you to hear that. But anyway, let's get into another complex verse by Tupac.
Got a way we do it, revolution, a premeditated scheme. Introduce a drug called crack to us ghetto teens. Got them off of raw niggas now, player what it be like. Raw niggas see they got us bleeding with three strikes. Can't seem to focus, hopeless, with violent thoughts I wrote this. Got these devils petrified, hiding from my hocus pocus. And so I learned to earn my currency in overtime. Click a military mind. Every mind give us, though we dwell inside a paradox. Thugged out and drug dealing from the room to the block. My live mind got me surviving five rounds. My 45 got me fortified with live rounds. When shit stick, we plot hits. When my Glock spits, all hell, I don't bear wrath, the Tupacalypse. Forever ghetto necessary, picture food stamps. Outlaw thug niggas never left the boot camp.
Now, that was complex. And that was slick. There was a line in there where Tupac said, my live mind got me surviving five rounds. My 45 got me fortified with live rounds. That was fire. That was straight fire. And you know the thing is, Tupac was such a boss, such a leader. If somebody would have came to Tupac and been like, yo, Pac, yo, give me more verses like that. Give me a whole 16 of you saying something like that. My live mind got me surviving five rounds. My 45 got me fortified with live rounds. Like, just keep going. Just keep going. Just keep going. Just keep doing that. If somebody would have came to Tupac and just spoke to him on some hip-hop shit, you know, he could have got on it. But, you know, but this right here, this particular verse, this is the Tupac after the shooting. This is the Tupac after the shooting. This is the Tupac after the prison. This is the Tupac after the rape case. This is the Tupac dealing with all his paranoia. This is the Tupac that said, prison ain't changed me, it made me worse. He was a live wire, ready to set it off. But we don't even need to touch that. We talking about lyricism. We talk about MCing. But y'all really need to understand, you got this. This is the Tupac that you came to know within the last years of 94, 95, 96. He became something different. He became something different. And he was conflicted with himself, battling himself, trying to do good for his people. But damn, he always, Tupac said, his mother said, yo, you out here, you want to save the world. Don't you know they're going to kill you? And that's it. That's what Tupac's mother told him. But that verse, a military mind, Tupac went in on that, bro. He went on that. He went in on that. It was complex. The complexity of Tupac. But don't come here and say, nah, that wasn't complex. I'm talking about the way MF Doom write. I'm talking about the way Tech Nine. I'm talking about the way MF Doom spit. I'm talking about the way Tech Nine spit. I'm talking about the way, you know, maybe Talib Kweli spit. I'm talking about all, you know, I'm talking about these technical rappers. You're comparing them. Why are you comparing them? Why are you putting them there? Why are you saying, why are y'all trying your best to destroy this man's lyrical legacy? Why? This man never ever said that he was the best rapper. He just said he was the realest. Tupac even told you, don't just bop your head to the beat. Listen to what he's saying and tell me if it's real and hold us accountable. That's what Tupac was. Let me say this real quick. I got mad love for Tupac, not just for the music, but for the all-around human being that he was. From his lectures, from his music, to his movies, from the way he handled certain things, from the way he tried to do good things for people. You know, he was giving out money when he was in New York, when he linked up with Nas and them. Tupac was just a different type of individual, man. It's not just the rapper that I love. It's the human being. It's a different type of person that nobody's ever seen. And that's why he's still relevant today. That's why Billboard put him at number 4. Way up there. A brother who's been dead for 27 years ain't made a song, and they put him way up there behind Nas, behind Kendrick, behind Jay-Z, in front of Eminem, in front of Biggie, in front of Lil Wayne, in front of Kanye, Rakim, in front of so many others. You know, it could be clickbait, but at the same token, though, Tupac is still relevant. Now, let's get into this one final verse of the complexity of Tupac.
That's the world, turns. Though I walk through the valley of hell, the shadow follows me. Wisdom hard to swallow. Tomorrow, expect apologies. You probably panic. Stranded in search of a better planet. Realism hard to understand. We stand slanted and still stranded. Merciless thieves stole the best of me. I pray to black Jesus to please take the rest of me and steal the best of us, build and reach monetary gains. Some of us kill, but still, most of us can change if we search deeper. God bless the hustler, curse the first sleeper. Enemy, get beside me. Flows go deeper beside me. Plots keep all my enemies blinded. Time will soon show. A folk can last for years. Outshine in your face, smiles, plastic tears. Like last year, niggas stuck in the past. And it's clear, just some buster ass bastards allergic to cash this year. Machiavelli for the mob, MOB. Killing busters is my motherfucking job. Him or me, lyrically fatally driven. Niggas reported missing. My competition dead or in prison. As the world turns.
The complexity of Tupac.